right, guys, we are going to have a reality chat, and this is going to be about love and marriage, Huntsville, and I'm just going to get right to it. I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time. And for those of you who have been watching these episodes and who have watched the prior seasons and also who have seen the reality of the situation with Martell and Melody Holt play out on social media, with interviews that they have done, with live videos that they have done, with all of the allegations and the things that have been proven about Martell being unfaithful during the marriage and now has another kid on the way while he has been married to Melody. You've all seen how Martell has treated his wife. Now, there have been some people who have not really even cared for Melody too much. I'm not saying anyone has said that she deserves the treatment that she has received by Martell, but a lot of people were not understanding why she would be with this punk. I'm just going to put it just like that. Because he has been extremely arrogant, has displayed narcissistic tendencies in the way that he has expressed himself about not only the marriage and how he feels that he hasn't been getting the treatment and that he feels he deserves and getting his needs met and being satisfied. I mean, everything has just been about him. So many people have wondered, why in the world would this woman stay with this guy? And not only just stay with him, because at the time they had 3 children together, but why in the world would she get pregnant and have another child with this man? And not only just get pregnant, but display it that they were working things out and this is Team Holt and all of these other things that they were trying to make work. But you know what? Even though I haven't watched this show faithfully over the past few seasons, I've seen what I've seen, and I know how some women will go the extra mile to the ends of the earth at some, you know, in some instances, to try to make the relationship work when they have children. Not just trying to make the relationship work for the sake of appearances and for the sake of the opinions of other people and trying to shut down how other people may feel about them and trying to prove other people wrong. Because yeah, there are some people that do that. There definitely are some people that do that. But with the situation with Melody, I don't know what it's like, and God bless her. I don't know what it's like to be married to an extremely narcissistic person. I'm sorry. I feel sorry for the woman because she's put up with a lot. She said she's been with this dude for, 14 or 15 years, and now they have 4 children together. But when I tell you on this last episode, I was screaming at the TV, and listen, I was screaming at the TV so loud that even my husband came downstairs and was like, what is wrong with you? Why are you yelling at the TV? Because I'm normally pretty quiet when it comes to watching television shows when I do watch TV. But when I watched this last episode, and it was the last portion of the show where they left this, I guess you would call it, impromptu counseling session, where she kind of got, you know, Melody was like blindsided because she wasn't expecting it, and that wasn't cool for her to be put on the spot like that. But for the show's sake and for the ratings' sake, it was great for us to watch because it was great TV. Even though this was a real life situation that was hurting her, but for us, it was great entertainment because it was a real thing and it wasn't something that was being played up for television. And the reason I say that is because you could feel the emotions of this woman when this a-hole is just pretty much tearing her down in front of this other couple that have had their own marital issues but care about both of them and wanted to see if it was worth a shot to have an impromptu counseling session and see if they could try to bring them together, even if it didn't happen right away, just to see if they could just chisel at the ice a little bit and break some things down and cause some open communication to really happen. But with a person like Martell, you cannot do that. See, in the previous episode, a number of things were revealed when it came to this guy, when it came to his mom, because his mom told him that you're a good man, and he's not. Martell is not a good man. Listen, taking care of your children, you're taking care of what you're supposed to do. That does not make you a good man. It just makes you a freaking human being. It does not make you a good man to do that. You're supposed to do that. Yeah, it makes you a terrible person if you don't, but it doesn't make you a good man if you do, because he treated his wife like trash, okay? He was disrespectful, unfaithful, uncaring, and in my opinion, he was also unfaithful to his children. And some people may not look at it that way, but when it comes to the way that he has torn apart this household, the children even said it. They said it to this woman who Melody has seen, I guess maybe for some therapy or some counseling. I don't remember her, or I don't remember how to pronounce her name. I don't know if it's Uma or something like that, but she was asking the children how they felt about everything. And you know, little kids, they can feel things. They definitely see things depending on what is displayed in front of them, but they can always feel things because all of this is energy, okay? And when one of her children said that, you know, I want to see my mom smile and be happy again, that almost made me cry to hear a little kid say that about their mom, because clearly she has really been going through it with this person. And I'm being kind when I call him a person, because I believe he's not even acting like that the way he's been treating her. But his mom said that, you know, you're a good man, when he admitted, after he admitted that he has another child on the way with his quote unquote mistress. And I'm being kind by even using that phrase. So she was sad about it. She wasn't happy about it. She shed a couple of tears. But she said, but you know, you're a good man. And I'm like, girl, he is not a good man. He's not. Call him out. I mean, there's really not much you can do at this point because he's a grown man. He's not in your care anymore. What's done is done. Apparently his dad was the same way. He's a horrible person, period. He's not a good man. And then him putting it out there that he's going to be filing for full custody of the kids. First of all, he knows that no judge in the United States in any of these family courts is going to grant him full custody. First of all, he does not have the capacity to take care of the children. And the mom even said that, because when Melody mentioned to his mom, when his mom came over to Melody's house to meet up and talk about things, you know, Melody said, well, you know, he said he's going to be filing for full custody. I mean, as soon as she said that, his mom was like, oh, no, he is not. No, no way. I'm not taking care of those kids, because she already knows that in the event that ever happened, which it never would, but just if he has visitation and on his weekends or weeks or whatever, there are going to be times where she's going to have more time with her grandchildren than he is going to have with his own kids, because he's not going to be doing daddy daycare. He's not. He's not even that type of person, period. He's not. And so his mom already knows that. So him putting it out there that he's going to be filing for full custody is just to hurt Melody. 100%. He just wants to hurt Melody. He's mad because of how he feels like he's being treated, or that she's got the nerve. Melody, like, how dare you file for divorce? How dare you try to leave me? You are the one that weren't taking care of me. You are the one that weren't meeting my needs. Like, that is the type of personality he has. So when he was saying those things at this impromptu counseling session on this latest episode, When Melody threw that glass at him, I honestly wanted her to hit him in the head with that glass. And call me what you want, but I felt that. When she threw that glass, I was like, yes. Yes, because you don't really see a whole lot of emotion coming from her. And she even said it. She was like, I keep a lot of stuff bottled up inside of me. So to be honest with you, her throwing that glass at him when he had the nerve to start coming back at her about how she wasn't meeting his needs and he wasn't getting satisfied and he had to go to this other person and she took care of me and she satisfied me. Like, what? You actually, like, what type of communication do you think you were going to have at that point? I was so glad to see her do that. I really wanted to see her get up there and throw hands. And I'm not condoning physical violence. I really am not. But for somebody like that, who has put this woman through so much over all of these years, we really don't know everything that they have gone through. But I am quite sure that the things that she has shared with us is really just the tip of the iceberg. I really believe that there is so much more that she has experienced at the hands of this person. And I wouldn't even be surprised if he has put his hands on her at some point. I really wouldn't be surprised. I'm not saying that he's done that, but I'm saying that if it came out that that happened, I would not be surprised, because this guy is scum. He is a slime ball. He is trash. He is a narcissist. He is garbage. And I can't stand this dude. I really can't. And I am so happy to see her moving forward. Listen, she better not take this person back ever, ever. Because she's done in my book if she does. And so one of the reasons I say that I was so happy to see her throw that glass at that point, because in the intro of the show, the two other couples, they're embracing each other. And then with her and him, she like puts her elbows up on his shoulder. Like that's something that you do with like a buddy or a friend, right? And I felt that was awkward. I felt like if they're going through a divorce, but they're filming this show together and they have to do this intro, I would have preferred to see like her back turned against his back, or maybe they give each other a scorn face or a mean mugging face or something like that, versus her putting her elbow up on his shoulder like, you know, this is my team partner, this is my my teammate, my buddy, my friend. I didn't get that, because when I saw that, especially when the season started, I was like, okay, what are we in for? What's up? You know, are they going to wind up getting back together? And again, the season isn't over, so we really don't know. But at that moment, I was like, yes, Melody, throw the glass, throw hands, throw whatever at this piece of garbage, because I cannot stand that guy. I really cannot. And he just has such an air of arrogance and narcissism that is just so disgusting. I really can't stand people like that. I wonder what his sign is. I don't really care, because it doesn't matter. Because honestly, no matter what his sign is, the main sign is a-hole. He's just trash. He's garbage. So anyway, guys, I'm going to end it here. I really want to know what you guys thought about this latest episode of Love and Marriage Huntsville. What do you think of Martell? Do you believe that Melody is going to just proceed and move forward and get this divorce finalized? What are your thoughts on this situation? Please let me know in the comment section, and I appreciate you liking, commenting, and subscribing. And until the next reality chat, I'm just being beautifully honest.